Myself Babida Matthew. Last class we discussed about the genetics and infection and cancer genetics. Today let us discuss about prenatal nutrition and food allergies. When moms to be eat apples during pregnancy, their offspring have lower rates of asthma. Studies shown that weekly if we eat 4 apples, there is very low chance of getting asthma to the babies. And mothers who have consumed fish during pregnancy may have lower their child risk of developing the allergic skin conditions called eczema. Next, we can see the factors of parental nutrition and food allergies in children. Mothers at high risk of having an infant with food allergies should consider avoiding peanuts during their third trimester. So peanuts usually causes allergies to the baby. So mother should not consume peanuts if they have family history of allergies, because there is a risk of getting infant these food allergies. Then conception of tuna sandwich. This is a tuna sandwich or milkshake during pregnancy will give baby food allergies. This genetic tendency called atrophy occurs when allergic individuals' immune system essentially go into overdrive when they come into contact with an allergen. An allergen refers to any substance such as pollen, molds, or animal dander, which can trigger an allergic response. So food allergies in children can cause a variety of problems that range from eczema to life-threatening allergic reactions. How can we prevent the food allergy? Here are some of the recommendations from American Academy of Pediatrics about the prevention of food allergy among the children. Do not eat peanuts during pregnancy. We already explained during pregnancy, if mother eats peanuts, there is a chance of getting baby the peanut allergy. Then it has been shown to increase the incidence of peanut allergy in children, and studies are inconclusive regarding their allergens such as egg, milk, fish, and given the essential role of these foods in providing balanced parental nutrition, no dietary restrictions are currently recommended. So we have to avoid peanuts during pregnancy. Then breastfeed exclusively for 6 months. That also can prevent the allergies to the children. By doing so, once reduce infants' exposure to cow's milk, and so the primary components in most infants' formula, that is exclusive breastfeeding, has been shown to lower rate of infant eczema and for good immune system. If it is not possible to breastfeed exclusively, choose hypoallergenic formula brands such as Enfamil, Nutramine, and Similac Aluminium. These are the best brands for the formula foods. Then avoid peanuts while breastfeeding. Again, studies have shown lower level of allergy when nursing mothers avoid peanuts. Then wait to start solid foods. That is, allergic eczema has found to be more common in kids fed solid before 6 months, and wait until child is 6 months old to reduce solid foods, especially if you have a family history of food allergies. Taking steps to prevent early exposure to food that can cause allergies too is a good idea. As a child grows older and the digestive system mature, the body is less likely to absorb food or food components that trigger allergies. Experts believe that waiting to introduce solid foods until your child is 6 months old may help prevent allergies to those foods. Then, next point is delay introducing allergic foods. The American Academy of Pediatrics suggests that children do not feed cow milk until they are 1 year old. Then egg should be avoided until 2, and peanuts and pernut and fish should be avoided until the kids are 3 years old. Introduce eggs at age 2, because This may help prevent your child from developing an egg allergy. Introduce nuts and seafoods at age 3. This may help prevent your child from developing allergy to these foods. Introduce all new foods gradually one at a time. Then give child cooked or homogenized foods, that is homemade food. Then soft unpasteurized sweet cheeses like feta cheese, brie, this is the feta cheese, next is the brie cheese and Camembert, this is Camembert cheese, and goat, as well as ready to eat meals like hot dogs, this is hot dog, and deli meals, this is deli meals, may contain listeria bacteria that cause mild flu-like symptoms in most adults but can be very dangerous for unborn babies. Listeriosis, the infection caused by bacteria in a pregnant mother, can cause miscarriage, premature birth, or severe illnesses or death of a newborn. Role of prenatal nutrition in prevention of genetic disorders. Folic acid supplementation to pregnant mother can reduce the risk of neural tube defects. Many of genetic disorders and birth defects are preventable through balanced prenatal and internatal diet of the mother. Down syndrome, also called trisomy 21, is a complex genetic disease that for years was said to be caused by an extra copy of chromosome 21. Children with the Down syndrome have an imbalance in the folate metabolism. Next is mitral valve prolapse. Majority of people with mitral valve prolapse are magnesium deficient, and that magnesium supplementation frequently reduces the or alleviate nerve symptoms. Wilson's disease. People with this inherited disorder have excess copper accumulation in their bodies. Zinc supplementation therapy used to reduce copper levels and has been successful in treating the disorder. Next is blue sclera. A feature of wide variety of connective tissue disorders, including Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, osteogenesis imperfecta, and Marfan syndrome. Most cases of blue sclera have been linked to iron deficiency. Next is cleft palate. Reduced significantly through maternal supplementation of folic acid. Spina bifida. It reduced significantly through maternal supplementation of multivitamins with folic acid. Cerebral palsy. Recent research shows that very low birth weight babies have a lower incidence of cerebral palsy when their mothers are treated with magnesium sulfate soon before giving birth. Next, we can see the maternal age and the genetic problems. Genetic aspects of advanced maternal age. An older mother have an increased risk of for miscarriage. Birth defects and pregnancy complications such as twins, high blood pressure, gestational diabetic, and difficult labors. The risk of having a baby with chromosomal abnormalities increase with maternal age. Down syndrome, that is trisomy 21, that is usually under 25 women have more chance. And trisomy 18 and trisomy 13 increase in advanced age. So what are the role of a nurse? Nurses need to ensure that any woman pregnant and over the age of 30 should talk with physician about individual health and discuss plan for helping and development of baby to maintain a healthy pregnancy. Next, pregnant mother with age of above 15 years should be referred to prenatal testing to diagnose or rule out chromosomal abnormalities and other genetic birth defects. Testing may help include blood test, ultrasound, chorionic villus sampling, or amniocentesis. You already studied these tests in previous classes. And nurses should provide details about the prenatal testing and support the woman during the prenatal testing. Nurses should help the woman and family to take decision about prenatal testing and termination of pregnancy if the fetus found to be with chromosomal abnormalities. Then, Nurses should plan and implement pre- and intraconception counseling about ill effects of advanced parental age. Next is the maternal drug therapy and about the genetic diseases. The use of drugs in pregnant and lactating women requires a thorough understanding of the unique interaction between the mother, fetus or infant and the pharmacologic agents that are used in therapy. Any agent that is consumed by a woman may have adverse effect on the fetus or infant. So any agent that is a woman consumed during her pregnancy that may adversely affect the fetus. Use of any drug during pregnancy and also in the lactation require extreme caution or prevention. The effects of pregnancy on drug disposition, pharmacokinetics. Oral availability. Gastrointestinal motility may be reduced during pregnancy and this may result in delayed absorption of orally administered drugs. Distribution. Maternal water and water content increases in pregnancy and may increase the volume of distribution of drug. Metabolism elimination. Maternal drug clearance often increases because of changes that include increased renal and hepatic blood flow and enzyme induction. This is the effects of pregnancy on drug, that is the pharmacokinetics during the pregnancy. The effects of drug on pregnancy and fetus or neonate, that is teratogenicity. A number of drugs are suspected of being teratogenic, but only a few have been identified with certainty. Even though many drugs are affected, but only few have the certain effects. The best known of these drugs is thalidomide, which was shown to give rise to a full range of malformations, including phocomelia, that is a short flipper-like appendages of all four extremities. You can see all extremities are very small, short flipper type. The other drugs known to cause fetal abnormalities are the antimetabolites that are used in the treatment of cancer, anticoagulants drugs, that is warfarin. Several of the anticonvulsant drugs. Some drugs affect a single developing structure. For example, prophylthiouracil can impair thyroid development. In fetal abnormalities such as cleft lip, heart defects, retinal and optic nerve abnormalities and CNS malformation were observed in women ingesting a therapeutic dose of drugs during the first trimester of pregnancy. Teratogenic effect of vitamin A, such as those contained in some dietary supplements of vitamin D. It is currently recommended that doses greater than 10,000 international units should be avoided. In 1963, the US Food and Drug Administration established a system for dating drugs according to the possible risk of the fetus. So it can be, it is categorized in five categories. That is, drug in category A are least dangerous drugs, and category B, C and D are increasingly more dangerous. Those in category X are contraindicated during pregnancy because of proven teratogenicity. Then what are the role of nurse in this drug administration? Educate mother to remember following basic principles regarding drug therapy during maternity period. Avoid all drugs in pregnancy were possible, especially in the first trimester. Herbal and other complementary therapies are often prescribed by a lay public as safe. Herbal remedies should be avoided during pregnancy. Consider tapering and discontinuing unnecessary pharmacotherapy prior to attempting the conception. So you can, if they are taking any drugs, if it affects the baby, it should be tapered or discontinued before attempting the conception. Many conditions are self-limiting and do not require drug treatment. So reassurance or lifestyle, that is such as some women may have migraine, and vomiting. These all can control by their lifestyle modification. So limit the drug. Then, where possible, delay treatment until after results of laboratory testing or until after delivery, that is a treatment of hypercholesterolemia, such conditions. If drug therapy is needed, select drugs with the most established safety record. Then, use of lowest effective dose for the shortest possible time. And poor control of some maternal disease states may carry significant risk to the development of the fetus. In addition, the severity or frequency of some maternal diseases such as migraine. Teach women that over-counter products including vitamin, herbals or iron are considered drugs should not be taken without discussion with her healthcare provider. Educate women as to the dangers of self-medication in pregnancy. And it is also important to realize that some mothers may be very anxious about the risk that their drug therapy poses to their baby. So this may lead to non-compliance with the drug therapy or necessary pregnancy termination. So before administering any drug to any woman in fertile age, does not forget to ask about her pregnancy status. Then consider every drug unsafe during pregnancy and try to avoid as far as possible. And question any prescription of the doctor if you find that drugs prescribed may be teratogenic. And provide preconception of prenatal counseling about harmful effects of drug on fetus if taken during pregnancy. Integrate the previous information into school health programs and provide teaching regarding related to non-pharmacological management to common conditions such as common cold can be managed by rest, steam inhalation and plenty of water. Anxiety can be managed by relaxation techniques instead of medication. Then involve the client in decision making if drug therapy is being considered as an informal pattern in their own care. Then instruct her to keep an accurate list of all medication ingested during pregnancy with the reason for which they are taken. And maintain a record of all prescriptions or recommended drugs with the same information. This should be in a hardly form for easy reference as the part of the patient profile. If drug therapy is necessary, the lowest effective therapeutic dose of the least toxic agent should be used. The risk and benefit should always be considered and doses should be individualized. Next, we can see the effects of radiations, drug and chemicals. Exposure to radiation Exposure to radiation during pregnancy can be teratogenic or harmful for embryo or fetus. In a given exposure during pregnancy, teratogen can have any of the following consequences. No apparent effect, prenatal or perinatal death, congenital anomalies, altered fetal growth, that is growth retardation, postnatal functional and behavior deficit and abortions and carcinogenesis. Factors influencing the effect of the teratogens. Agents agents often act differently in different species and on individuals with the same species with a place to both the mother and the fetus. The age of the fetus is at the time of exposure. Generally, when exposed to agents affecting the period from fertilization to implantation, the result is either death or regeneration during period of organogenesis. Agent assesses to and disposition within the fetus. The chemical, biological and physical properties of the agent. How varying effects. Interactions with other agents and factors can have negative consequences. Level and duration of dosage or exposure influence the agent's effect. Maternal biochemical pathway and mechanisms for handling drugs and chemicals are altered by pregnancy. The degree of interference with the maternal system and the extent of modulation that occurs determine the effects on the fetus. The genetic constitution of both the mother and the fetus, dizygote twins, have been born with one having anomalies typical of the drug effect, whereas the other was normal. Next weekend is the effects of chemicals and drugs. Environmental chemicals and drugs can cross the placenta and cause damage to the developing embryo and fetus. Some of the best documented environmental teratogens are the organic mercurials, which cause neurologic defects and blindness. Sources of exposure to mercury include contaminated food such as fish and water. Chemicals and drugs may have cytotoxic, that is cell-killing, and demetabolic or growth-inhibiting properties. Often their effects depend on the time of exposure, in terms of embryonic or fetal development and extent of exposure. Drugs including alcohol and illicit drugs top the list of chemical teratogens. Most drugs can cross the placenta and expose the fetus to both the pharmacologic and teratogenic effects. What are the factors that affect the placental drug transfer and drug effect on fetuses include the rate at which the chemical or drug crosses the placenta, the stage of placental and fetal development at the time of chemical or drug exposure. So when the drug exposed, what was the stage of development of placenta. Next, alcohol. The features of fetal alcohol syndrome occurs in 30 to 40 of babies born to chronic alcoholics. Another 50 to 70% of such babies may suffer from fetal alcohol effects, which is milder than FAS. To be diagnosed with FAS, a baby must have the following features: growth retardation, central nervous system problem, characters of facial appearance, that is small head, flat facial profile, thin upper lip. Other major birth defects such as heart, gastrointestinal, etc. are possible. And children with FAS have failure to thrive, mild, moderate mental retardation and behavior problems. FAS is the most preventable cause of mental retardation. EAS, not FAS. Then thalidomide, well-known teratogen leading to limb defects in exposed babies. This medication to prevent morning sickness are not used anymore. Cigarette smoking. Constant exposure to cigarette smoke is the amount of oxygen crosses the placenta and can lead to low birth weight and premature babies. Cocaine, street drugs, omitted. The street drugs increase risk for having babies born addicted to the drug. The biggest risk of babies are not from the drug themselves, but due to poor maternal nutrition and lack of prenatal care. There are many prenatal complications due to even one exposure to cocaine are miscarriage, placental abruption, vascular defects, then in utero strokes, increased risk of SIDS, infant drug withdrawal syndrome. Then anticonvulsants, exposure to anti-seizure medication is associated with fetal convulsion syndrome. Lithium, exposure to lithium is associated with an increased risk of congenital heart defects. And vitamin A, women taking oral vitamin A have a high risk of having baby with major birth defects, including hydrocephaly, mental retardation, malformation of ears, facial abnormalities and heart disease. What a role of nurse? Be proactive. To preconception counseling, which should include some of the current alcohol and drug use, environmental exposure and smoke, and provide education. And female of reproductive age seen in various settings should be taught that medication and social drugs exposure of certain type can affect the fetuses, especially in the first trimester. Then she may not realize she is pregnant. This should include the danger of medication sharing. Encourage the client to tell physician, nurse and other health practitioners involved in her care that she is pregnant, and identify those most those most likely to be users of medication and drugs and inform those who are considering pregnancy or who are already pregnant above the hazards and effects of radiations. Ionizing radiation have been shown to cause microcephaly, skeletal malformation and mental retardation. Reported risk of non-ionizing radiations include electromagnetic field emitted from the computers, microwave communication system, microwave ovens, power illness lines, cellular phones, household appliances, heating pads and warming blankets, airport screening devices for metal objects, and diagnostic levels of ultrasound is minimal if even existent. Next, we can see radiation risk during different stages of fetal development. In early fetal period, it is minimum, maximum risk is in the early fetal period, and less risk is in the second trimester, and least risk in the third trimester. How can we minimize the risk of medical radiation procedure? Healthcare providers need to follow the following principle to minimize the harmful effects of radiation on growing fetus. All medical radiation practices, occupational and patient related, should justify before performing more benefit than the risk. And medical radiation exposure should be justified for each patient before they are performed. After it is decided to do a medical radiation procedure, fetal radiation dose should be reduced and while still obtaining the required diagnostic information. Radiation therapy and interventional fluoroscopically guided procedures may give fetal doses in the range of 10 to 100 Gy more depending on the specifics of the procedure, which is considered safe during the pregnancy. After higher dose medical procedures have been performed on pregnant patients, fetal dose and potential fetal risk should be estimated by the knowledgeable person. And most nuclear medicine diagnostic procedures are done with short-lived radionuclides, such as Tecentrinol-99m, that do not cause large fetal doses. Often fetal dose can be reduced through the maternal hydration and encourage voiding of urine. If any dose is given, we have to give more amount of food, so when voiding of urine, it can be eliminated. Some radionuclides do cross the plasma and can pose fetal risk. Therefore, use of such radionuclides should be discouraged during pregnancy. The fetal thyroid accumulates iodine after about 10 weeks of gestational age. High fetal thyroid doses for radioiodine can result in permanent hypothyroidism. If pregnancy is discovered within 12 hours of radioiodine administration, prompt oral administration of stable potassium iodine to the mother can reduce the fetal thyroid dose, and this may lead to repeated several times. And a number of radionuclides are excreted in breast milk. It is recommended that breastfeeding is suspended as follows: completely after the therapy, 3 weeks after 131 GA, NA and therapy, 12 hours after hippurate and all MUTE components except fourth after the red cells, DPA and phosphonates. What are nurses' role? Nurses should be proactive in assessment of women regarding pregnancy before conducting any radiodiagnostic or radiotherapeutic interventions. Estimate risk-benefit ratio for any radiological intervention. Take an internet consent from patient after discussing the potential expected risk of medical radiation on fetus before any medical radiation procedure. Provide radiation protective devices, that is when we are taking the x-ray. Women during the radio diagnostic procedure, like lead jackets during the x-ray studies. And provide antenatal education to women about the reproductive risk of exposure to radiation. Conduct several school health programs to enhance awareness of children about reproductive risk of exposure to radiation sources in pregnant age. That's all about the genetical effects, maternal and prenatal genetical effects. So we discuss about the different aspects such as the infection, consanguinity, and age and the problems in the pregnancy, radiation and drugs effect, food allergies and the maternal intake of foods and the allergies to the children. So I think all of you clearly understood. Thank you.